Eagle River, District 14. Thank you so much for your time, Senator. So what's your take on local mandates regarding COVID-19?
The decisions in regards to the mandates are pretty much exclusively being done at the executive level. So that would be the local mayor, the governor, or possibly even at the presidential level. Typically, the president has been deferring these decisions to the state officials. I know there's confusion of which supersedes another, whether the mayor supersedes the governor, etc. And I really want to encourage everybody to go ahead and call the mayor's office or the governor's office for clarification in regards to that, because the legislative branch is pretty much being excluded from those types of decisions.
Senator, what are your thoughts on our U.S. Attorney General's actions against the coronavirus pandemic?
He is investigating and making sure that the mandates do not cross the line and violate people's constitutional rights. As you know, every elected official has to swear to uphold and defend the Constitution. So I really want to encourage people to read the state constitution and the federal constitution and know what your rights are. But also, please look out for yourself and those around you.
And what have you been working on during this legislative recess?
So it's been really busy. I've been getting a lot of phone calls in regards to the mandates and what people are allowed and not allowed to do. So I'm trying to connect my constituents with the right people. Also, there's been considerable number of emails in regards to this. The legislature typically has two very important responsibilities. One is the budget, and two is legislation, either pushing legislation or actually trying to stop legislation that you disagree with. So the budget is one of the most important issues to the people of Alaska right now. And so I'm writing some op-eds in regards to what is going on with the budget. How big is the budget? What do our savings accounts look like? Why is the permanent funds dividend being used right now to fund government? How does Alaska compare with other states in regards to the budget? And basically, there's some very tough decisions ahead because a lot of our savings accounts are being cleared out at this time. And so is your state representative or your state senator tough enough to make decisions? Are they going to reduce government? Or are they going to impose taxes and continue to take your permanent funds dividend? So watch for those op-eds that will be hopefully published in the newspapers and also put up on my Facebook. That's Senator Lora Reinbold on my Facebook. Also, one thing that I'm working on with my staff, Kelly Toth, is a disaster plan. There's a lot of people at town halls that were asking questions about, what are we going to do if there's another big fire? What if there's another earthquake? What's the plan for our community? And so my staff and I are working with very much many people at the agency levels, and we're also working with local volunteers to try to put a plan together. We're hoping to get a draft plan for the disaster plan together by June 15th.
Thank you all for tuning in tonight. I hope you enjoyed the little clip I was able to capture of Senator Lora Reinbold on the news tonight. This is one senator. If you are in her district, re-vote her in again. 6 years in a row, she has voted her conscience. That has been exactly what the Alaskans that she represents has asked her to do. She is the only senator that I am aware of in the last 6 years that has voted exactly as she has promised to do when she got elected. Again, thanks for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed the show. Have a great night.